Okay, thank you very much. My name is Mike Moran. I'm Chief Operating Officer at ThinQ, and this is Eric Leon, who's our Executive Vice President. What we're going to talk to you today is about least cost routing in the cloud. And what I'm going to start with at first is just kind of, hopefully maybe to tie the presentations we've seen earlier today together. Let's think about the cloud evolution for a second, and then least cost routing's position within that. For the purposes of this room and the cloud, our universe has existed for about 15 years. And in 2000, when the cloud as a business environment was becoming more and more prevalent, the first opportunities to present themselves were kind of the infrastructure in the cloud. And then around 2007, you started seeing the platform as a service, and then software as a service. And today, what we're seeing is more of a business process as a service. And if you think of least cost routing, that's really a business process as a service where you're outsourcing a component. Like, you could be outsourcing your HR, you could be outsourcing your payroll, you could be outsourcing, in our instance, least cost routing. Now, as communications developers, you may or may not be familiar with LCR. You may purchase your communications as a flat rate, where you're buying at a flat rate per minute, or you could be buying it on a bulk in trunks. What we're doing is providing the ability to route in a least cost environment instead of the bulk purchasing. And to do that, think about it in terms of in the U.S., in the communications market, if you think of the NPA-NXX as how you would route a phone call, you've got about 175,000 NPA-NXXs. Then you've got the jurisdiction issue of whether it's interstate or intrastate. So, and then you've got multiple carriers backing that up. So a least cost routing engine is, of course, taking those hundreds of thousands of NPA-NXXs, analyzing the jurisdiction and analyzing carriers en route to determine whether or not you're going to capture it from a or how you're going to capture it in a least cost routing environment. Now, in terms of what ThinQ does, we provide that service, and that's what so we're going to hear talk about that today. But we do a couple of things in addition to that. We do the termination least cost routing, but we also do origination. We do CNAM, LRN, and when we're building other products and platforms down the road. And we appreciate the ability to be here in front of you today, and also we appreciate our partnership with 2600Hz. So let's start by asking a question, and that's, as a developer, what does it take to build the best network for your customers? Well, you're going to need a variety of features and functionalities, and you probably would think about it first in terms of over-the-top communications capabilities. So you're going to want to have your SMS, you want to have video capabilities, you're going to want to have your voice capabilities. And then you can kind of subdivide those down within voice. You're going to have, obviously, the origination, the termination. You're going to have the features and functionalities around with that, but you're also going to want to have the analytics and the ability to monitor and control a lot of the things that you're developing today. So that's, combined what you'll need to get that solution for your customer base. So then there's the business components to that, not just the technology aspects, but there's the getting the carrier agreements in place. It's getting the most competitive pricing. It's the routing options that you'll need, and the analytics for your customers so that you can provide them with everything they'll need to manage their network and their communications platforms with you. Now, one thing that most customers aren't probably going to understand, though, is that there's no one carrier solution. Nobody's everywhere, and so in order to build the best network available, you're going to have multiple carriers and multiple technologies integrated together. So with that, what I'm going to do is hand this over to Eric, and Eric's going to actually walk you through a demonstration.
Okay, is this one's on? All right. Okay, so the resolution's a little bit off, so you're going to have to bear with me. I'm going to have to do a bit of scrolling here. But along with what Mike was saying, the traditional carrier model is difficult, right? We have to obtain the relationships upstream. We need multiple providers. We need a solution that's going to allow us to wrap between them by whatever logic we want to utilize. And the idea here behind the LCR platform is to kind of streamline that process, right? Everything from the carrier access to the carrier management tool. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to kind of break this into two parts. And the first part that I want to look over here is take this. This is a ThinQ account. We can only see a little bit of it, but I'm going to scroll down here. Okay. So the first aspect is the carrier access. We knew, because it's so hard to get these relationships, that we had to cultivate them for our customers. So what we did was we went out and we grabbed onto every major carrier from every major segment. I'm not going to go into too much detail about what RBOX and CLEX are. I'm sure a lot of you are already familiar. But the idea behind it is we're trying to leverage the best of what everybody's doing out there, right? And we're trying to turn that into a least cost routing scenario. One of the things that the platform first shows you is the ability to activate or disable providers in real time, right? Again, this is totally different than the traditional carrier model. We didn't have to call somebody up, negotiate a contract, interop with them, figure out whether that interoperability was working. The minute we have access to the platform, we can instantaneously click a toggle button, and we've just, for this case, AT&T's domestic, we just launched in 175,000 routes into our routing platform. It tells the system, okay, every time you send me a call, I want you to route it over AT&T. Now, the power comes when we start to activate a second, and obviously this is pretty straightforward, so everybody probably knows where I'm going with this. But now what the system knows to do is, between AT&T and CenturyLink, it understands per route, per jurisdiction, which one is going to be most price competitive for your business, right? So it forces carriers into a highly competitive scenario in which carriers who are better point of presence or who have less hops to the destination are going to be more price competitive and therefore earn your business. Carrier access is all well and good. The next feature set that I kind of want to illustrate quickly here is the additional tools. And what the additional tools are, some customers need to be able to build, varying product lines for their customers. So what we're actually looking at here is what's called a profile on our system. And a profile is a routing strategy. It allows the customer to come in, pick a bunch of different providers, choose the methodology that they want to route for. In this case, I've selected what we call a cap LCR. What this allows me to do is I can actually set a predetermined cap per route. It's not the overall price of the call. What it tells the system is, I don't care how many carriers the customer selected, you're always going to go to the most price competitive carrier. But if, for some reason, that call is over 5/10 of a penny, I want you to reject the call and send it back to the customer. So customers can build flat rate products for certain, customer segments. And it's probably a little bit more important when it comes to international routing, which I can show you here in a second. So great, we've got access to a bunch of different providers. We've enabled it into an LCR scenario. The thing that always gets me when we talk to customers is that there's a difficulty managing the upstream providers from a troubleshooting standpoint, right? The example that I always generally bring up is, as a familiar one, would be your customer calls you up and they say, hey, I was trying to put my credit card in over the phone. It wouldn't let me dial it. Well, we know that that's a DTMF issue, right? But the customer doesn't understand it. They don't understand why they can do it from their cell phone, but they can't do it from their office phone. And under the traditional carrier model, that requires you to call up your carrier, open up a ticket, right? They might, if I'm going to make it dramatic, they might ask you to, let's say, reproduce the problem, do something like a packet capture on it, and open it up in a program like Wireshark. Does this sound familiar to anybody out there right now? So in that same example, I want to apply that to what the ThinQ LCR platform allows you to do. And that starts with what we call diagnostics. So if we're going to provide real-time carrier access and we're going to allow real-time LCRing between those carriers, we're going to have to back it up with the diagnostic tools to troubleshoot problems when they arise. Because like Mike was illustrating, the unfortunate side of this business is no one carrier is good all the time and no one carrier is good everywhere, right? So what the query tool allows us to do is set a predetermined time, ANI, caller ID, or DID, however you want to do it. In this case, I'll ping Let me ping the fifth just so that I know that there's something on this account. Let me see, fifth. Bear with me one moment here. Okay. So what I've defined here is the time and a date in which I want to query the call. So if the customer information is already given to you, hey, I made the call at 12 o'clock, you'd know that. If you know the ANI or the DID or the caller ID, you could ping that as well. So if I scroll down here and I run a query, what it's going to do here is, bear with me. It's going to pop up real-time CDR data associated with that call. So by the time your customer finishes completing that call that caused an issue and they call you up about 10 seconds later, you're actually able to retrieve the data from that actual call. And it's going to give you, at a surface level, all the pertinent information. It's going to give you the caller ID, the carrier number that the call went across, and so forth down the line. But for those of us who have a lot of experience with, you know, doing packet captures on calls to diagnose even deeper issues, we actually provide that as well. So if I were to click on this little view trace button, what's going to pop up here in a second. All right, well, while that's loading, what's actually going to pop up here is a full ladder diagram of that actual call. So you can actually see, in this case, we've got an asterisk in the ThinQ office, and it's bumping through to a couple load balancers. And then ultimately, Brightlink completed the call, carrier number 64. Now, in an LCR scenario, we also want to understand upstream what's happening at every level, right? So if this, for some reason, hit a carrier and the carrier failed the call and it went over to the next cheapest carrier, we would actually see that information stated here. So we could diagnose problems way quicker than having to contact our carrier, open up a ticket, and maybe wait 72 hours for them to respond. Okay, great. So I've got that information. I've got the CDR data. If I want to, I can quickly open a ticket inside of the system, and it's going to ping ThinQ and to hold them responsible for managing the carrier and resolving that issue. But let's say we wanted to dig just a little bit deeper. Sorry, this resolution is so hard to navigate. We have something called a route block feature. So in the LCR scenario, we've diagnosed exactly what carrier completed the call, and we've identified that maybe that carrier needs to be removed. And logic tells us we could go back to the LCR platform because it's in real time. We could turn the carrier off. And for some cases, that might make sense, right? You know, for those of us who are trying to build, you know, the most robust network, we might have determined that that carrier is no longer appropriate for us. But for others, they're going to understand, hey, that was a call across, let's say, AT&T. Went across AT&T and, you know, I love AT&T. They give me great routes and they give me great pricing. So maybe I just want to selectively remove AT&T. So if I were to click on the route block feature, this is going to bring us to an option page. It's going to allow us to select how to surgically remove routes from a carrier, right? So in this case, let's say that call went to 310 Los Angeles, right? 404. Under this criteria, I've decided that the first six digits is what I'm going to utilize in order to route remove from a provider. I could also go by, for those of you who are familiar, LATAs and OCNs. I can remove rate centers and I can remove entire states. But in this case, let's run a query on 310-404. MPNXX. Thank you. Good catch. And you were exactly right. So in this case, it's pinging us back and it's giving us the MPA and XX. If we had done it by any of the other categories, it would have filled that in, right? So I could have pinged 310 and said I wanted to remove by state, and it would have kicked me back that I was going to be removing all of California from a select provider. And then what I've done here, what I'll do here is I'll create a route block. So what it's going to do is, for whatever routing strategy that I created, right? So if I created a routing strategy for my business enterprise customers, right? I could pop up the profile associated with that business enterprise right here and select the carrier, set of carriers that was offending. So let's say Brightlink, number 64. They were the issue. If I were to save it off, it Immediately, it's going to list that Eric Leon created a block for Brightlink at MPA NXX 310404. I actually already created those other ones beforehand, so I don't know why they're listed there. But anyway, you know, I think what we're trying to streamline here is the idea that if we can quickly do carrier modifications, we can quickly introduce new providers into the mix for our network. If we can do all this in near real time, it gives us a chance to really experiment at a level we really never had before, right? I mean, I talk to large level telcos all the time, and they're only working in general with like around 7 providers. And the reason for that is because the carrier model breaks down, right? It just becomes too difficult to manage yet another interop, yet another interconnect, and another rate negotiation. So we're kind of trying to pool everything together into the real time set of tools. And that's it. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Any questions? Yes.
You only operate in the US?
No, we also, well, our company's only here in the United States, but we offer, and I should have probably shown you that, we do offer both domestic carriers and international carriers in both LCR scenarios. So under the profiles tab, I would have just selected create a new profile. And I can create both an international or domestic profile. Sorry, it's so hard to navigate on this page. Any other questions?